माता पिता ने जब जन्म दिया तब से तो मैं जैनी बन ही गया। भगवान आदिनाथ और महावीर विरासत में ही मिल गए, परंतु जैसे इंसान बनने की प्रक्रिया शुरू हुई तब मेरे ध्यान में ये आया कि भगवान और इंसान के बीच में एक दैवत भी होना चाहिए, और उस दैवत की जब खोज में था तो गांधी जी मेरे सामने आए। और मैं मानता हूँ कि मेरे जीवन का सबसे बड़ा सपना इस गांधी तीर्थ के रूप में आपके सामने।
Spread across 500 acres of peaceful, pollution-free, green mango orchards in the scenically landscaped Jain Hills is Gandhi Teerth. A symbol of humanism, this memorial is a unique example of workmanship. The memorial in itself is the result of the efforts of around more than 700 masons and sculptors who completed the structure in mere 16 months and 20 days. Built to last for years, this memorial can withstand even an earthquake measuring 8.5 on the Richter scale. Right from the time of its construction, preservation of the environment has been kept in mind. Gandhi Teerth has been certified as a green building based on the 5-star rating given by Grih and a platinum rating awarded by LEED. Apart from these, this structure has also won 2 national awards. For its environment preservation, it has also been given an ISO 18001:2004 certification, and for its environment safety system, it has been awarded an ISO 18001:2007 certification.
So I think it was a beautiful journey, and it was a self-revealing thought. Bade Bahu had briefed us in one single line beautifully, saying that I want to showcase Gandhi in the most humane manner and showcase all that he did in the most straightforward manner. So this was the beginning in terms of our thought process, our conceptual process, our research process. So this was actually the start point which had driven us. And you'll see many installation, many stories unfolding through this museum, always showcasing Gandhi as an individual, ordinary, down-to-earth man. So this was the start point for us in terms of how we started our conceptual process.
We had a very clear kind of a brief from Bade Bahu that he had read, and he had made sure everybody involved with the project had read the experiments with truth. And his point was that Gandhiji at his time was a wonderful communicator. He could influence this entire large nation. Correct. And all around the world to kind of have this impetus towards our freedom movement. That kind of an effect will come when we are again able to tell the story in a way which is relevant to our large audiences, which are completely youth. India is made up of young people right now. And to pass on that torch of ideas, we need to be able to tell this to them in their language. So there's a wonderful mix in this museum of traditional mediums, of things which hold on to the value of Gandhism. At the same time, bring it together with technology and language which the youth understand, not only in India, but across the world. So that was the universal language and approach that we wanted to have in this museum.
Our
आर्किटेक्चरल दृष्टि से देखा जाए तो एक बहुत ही आकर्षक और इम्पोर्टेंट चीज़ यह है कि यह ग्रीन बिल्डिंग है। आज भारत में ग्रीन बिल्डिंग में म्यूज़ियम के तौर पे ये मेरे हिसाब से ये पहली बिल्डिंग होगी। आर्किटेक्चर के स्टूडेंट्स लोग इसको वो दृष्टि से देखने और परखने तो आते ही है, और साथ में हमने यहाँ जो पर्यावरण की जो सुरक्षा की है तो वो पर्यावरण की सुरक्षा हमें गांधी जी के पास लेके जाती है।
मैं ऐसा मानता हूँ कि संस्कार करने नहीं पड़ते, संस्कार हुआ करते हैं वातावरण में से। इसलिए वो वातावरण निर्माण करने की आवश्यकता है, और वो वातावरण निर्माण करने की कोशिश करने के पीछे ये गांधी तीर्थ की भूमिका है। उसके लिए गांधी तीर्थ उपस्थित हुआ, प्रस्तापित हुआ। ये पर्यटन क्षेत्र से भी तीर्थ क्षेत्र से जुड़ा हुआ पर्यटन क्षेत्र है। यहाँ पर्यटक कम जाएंगे, यात्री ज़्यादा जाएंगे ऐसा मैं मानता हूँ, क्योंकि भूमिका यात्री की होगी तो फिर गांधी को समझना आसान है। और नाम भी इसका हमने तीर्थ दिया, हमने गांधी तीर्थ कहा। पुराना बहुत अच्छा वाक्य है कि जीवन के बारे में लिखा है कि बह गए से वो गंगा है और रह गया वो तीर्थ है। तो गांधी के जीवन तो हमने जान लिया, भाव हुआ। अब जीवन में से जो बचा है वो जो तीर्थ है गांधी के विचारों का, उसके कार्य का, उसको जानने के लिए इस गांधी तीर्थ को हमने आपके सामने प्रस्तुत किया है, और यही हमारी इसके पीछे की भूमिका है।
The first section starts with his early childhood experiences. For someone of this age and time, it's difficult to understand his environment and what he grew up around. There is a wonderful nostalgic tinge to his memories when he writes about it in his book. So what we wanted to do is that not only talk about what were his main influences, but give them a glimpse of the kind of context that he was from. Because when you grow up, there are these subtle things which affect you, which you do not realize at that time, but it's in hindsight that you realize them, which is what happened with Gandhiji. So that space we have designed with a lot of elements that are from his childhood. We've not recreated his home, both in Porbandar and Rajkot, but we've taken elements, architectural elements. So you'll see the window, you'll see the door, you will see the Jain miniature painting style. You will see that there are these digital books which are kept. And there is this colorful bioscope right in the center. Ideally, traditionally, the bioscopes are not so big. It is the idea of the bioscope, which Gandhiji also saw when he was a child and he was very fascinated by it. We want to bring the same fascination to the child who sees it now. At the same time, using that as the medium externally. Internally, it is completely modern. So Gandhiji, when he was seeing a traditional bioscope, he was seeing maybe a few images. Now, this child who is understanding Gandhiji's story is looking into a large, colorful bioscope which has been painted by local artists. And when you see within that, you see a digital screen which showcases a film about his childhood to understand very emotively his parents' influences, the other influences, cultural influences around him.
मेरी माँ पुतलीबाई एक करुणामयी और साध्वी स्त्री थी। वे कठोरतम संकल्पों का निर्वाह करते हुए भी अपने दैनिक कार्यों को खुशी-खुशी करती जाती थी। मुझे बायोस्कोप में देखी श्रवण कथा की तस्वीरें आज भी याद हैं। राजा हरिश्चंद्र नाटक ने मेरे हृदय पर गहरा प्रभाव डाला। मेरा जी करता था कि मैं उसे पाऊं।
You, come along. You must go to the van compartment.
But I have a first-class ticket.
That doesn't matter. I tell you, you must go to the van compartment.
I tell you, I insist on traveling in this compartment.
If you won't leave, I will have to throw you out.
I was left standing, alone, bereft, shivering from the extreme cold and the humiliation.
I think it's a very innovative state-of-the-art technology that has been used. Children of today and the future generations that will come to see this museum, they will be awed and inspired by the technology used. So it's a great achievement, I think.
First reaction, it's awesome. The staff is extremely well trained and they show you and explain to you perfectly well every situation. You have ample time to realize, read, understand and absorb every thought.
इसके लिए पूरे दुनिया भर से कलाकार ने उसमें अपना सहयोग दिया है। ग्रीन बिल्डिंग के साथ साथ यहाँ पर्यावरण के हिसाब से इसकी एनर्जी जो है वो पूरे रिन्यूएबल तौर से यूज़ हुई है। आप देखते हैं देखेंगे अंदर पूरी जो लाइटिंग है ये सोलर पे की हुई है और एसी और बाकी के इक्विपमेंट के लिए हमने बायोगैस का यूज़ किया है। बायोगैस जनरेटर के थ्रू हम इलेक्ट्रिसिटी निर्माण करके वो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इसको देते हैं।
My first reaction in just one word is outstanding. In two words, it is absolutely outstanding. But what I really feel is that this is really a path-breaking experiment here. It's really one of its kind, the first of its kind, and I have not seen anything even halfway comparable to this in any of the museums that I have seen. And I have traveled a lot all over Western Europe, all over Asia actually. I've seen some of the greatest museums of the world, and yes, they are fine, but there is something unique here, and that is the use of the audiovisual technology or the highest quality, and of course the message. And beyond that, what is so special about this place is the grandeur, the feeling that it evokes, and all of that in a very small town in Maharashtra, India, which has never been considered as a world's greatest tourist spot or anything like that before now, but I think it will be from now on. Not only all the industries that Bhav can showcase here, Bhav Lal Bhai, but beyond that, this Gandhi Center is going to be a crown jewel in their achievements here. So, yes, very special.
Visitors from far off places come to visit the Gandhi Teerth. Modern amenities are made available. For staying, visitors can book the ashram, where around 100 people could be accommodated at a time. Along with that, local vegetarian cuisine is also served. All primary facilities like car parking, helipad, medical facilities are also made available. The work and research of Gandhi Research Foundation through this museum is aimed at educating the present and the future generations about the life, philosophy, and the works of Gandhi. Today, Gandhi Teerth is making inspirational progress in inculcating human values and in achieving the goal of being critical of politics, not only for our country, but also for the entire world. Through the film Making of Gandhi Teerth, an attempt is being made to introduce viewers, activists, philosophers, intellectuals, and tourists of the world over to Gandhi Research Foundation and the Gandhi Memorial Museum, the Gandhi Teerth. We sincerely hope that through this film, we succeed in doing so.
अहिंसा का नियम तो ये है कि जो कुछ भी करो वो अपनी मर्यादा में होना चाहिए, उसमें मूर्छा नहीं होनी चाहिए, अभिमान नहीं होना चाहिए, पूरी पूरी नम्रता होनी चाहिए। मेरी उम्मीद है कि मैं जो आज कर रहा हूँ उसमें ये सब चीज भरी है, न अभिमान है, नम्रता है, मुझको मूर्छा नहीं है, ज्ञान से, शुद्ध ज्ञान से मैं ये काम कर रहा हूँ। तो ईश्वर जैसा चाहता है वही होने वाला है।
कि गांधी जी ने जो भी कहा वो किसी एक समय के लिए नहीं था, हर समय के लिए वही संदेश है। और जैसे जैसे दुनिया में, जैसे जैसे समाज में आतंकवाद फैलेगा, जैसे जैसे समय बीतने से और असुरक्षितता बढ़ेगी, वो सभी के ऊपर एक स्थायी स्वरूप से कोई इलाज है, वो जो गांधी जी ने बताया है। केवल मैं ये नहीं कह रहा हूँ, सभी राष्ट्र दुनिया के, सभी राष्ट्रों के जो अध्यक्ष हैं वो सभी ये कह रहे हैं। और इसलिए एक जो सपना देखा था वो वास्तव में आते हुए बहुत आनंद और समाधान को मैं महसूस करता हूँ। जब सोचता हूँ तो आँखों में आंसू ढल आते हैं और दिमाग चकरा जाता है। यह आंसू काहे के हैं, यह आनंद के हैं, समाधान के।
वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए चले चले।